Haven't seen anything unbelievable yet.
Shrinking began. Hot sand was poured into the cavity. The head was kept constantly in motion in order to get the sand even all over the head. As the sand cooled off, it was reheated and placed back in the head, which was scraped each time with a knife to remove the burnt tissue. Gradually, as the head touched, the Jabara worked the functions with his hands, placing a mold in the fire to preserve the skin. The mouth pad was opened and replaced with long strings and earrings of exotic flowers.
Thank you.
By the 19th century, beyond police, Robert Ripley.
Among the Yano and Amos Indians of southern Venezuela and Brazil, there's a strange belief. They believe the soul of a dead villager should be celebrated by sharing his remains at lunch, literally. First, the body is cremated until nothing remains but the bones and ashes. Then the bones are carefully collected.
I look like Morgan Freeman a little bit.
And saved. When the time seems right, the soup is made from the ashes, and the bone is passed around. In the jungle, one food is more plentiful than any other. You might call it nature's fast food. It's easy to prepare. Just strain and saute. No waste, nothing to bring up. Just bite-sized morsels of pure protein. And once they stop squirming, everyone agrees they're delicious. One of the real delicacies of bush eating is the crocodile. These big bodies get attached, so when they're cooked and served, it's a cause for celebration. They're big too. One croc will feed 40. The whole village can share the meal. And of course, everyone has their favorite part. But like turkey at Christmas, the big attraction is plenty of leftovers. With or without cranberry sauce, you just can't beat crocodile for stews, casseroles, and just good eating right off the carcass. Everyone has different customs regarding food. But before you marvel too much at the strangeness of the village or assimilate a cheese snack, you may want to switch to spiders. Believe it or not. Ranges from the sublime to, well, things that scuttle, slither, and slink. What one culture calls meat, another may call critters. Discover.
They did not go to the moon, y'all.
In both 1926 and 1929, Robert was in both the living and the life. He was the boy who kept growing and growing. He was overlapping and continued very much. But the rest of his brothers and sisters were normal size. He could have surpassed his friends at the same age and both height and weight. And he could have been 6 pounds, 7 feet 3 inches.
Some people say I have some sort of superability. But it's my preparation, training, and dedication that enables me to do what I can do. They said my skull is one of the thickest they ever x-rayed. 2.3 times more thick than the average skull.
First, they removed the ring by teasing.
freaking artifacts again.
Thank you. sword takes the same path, but the food takes to get from the mouth into the stomach. Let me show you how the swallowing is being done.
Sometime in the 1930s, according to tribal legend, Rashur cut his fertility. Statues of him placed on either side of a doorway leading to a bedroom. Far from being a beautiful fisherman, the face, while moderately human in appearance, carried an indescribable look of horror that terrified most people. Back in the 1830s, thousands of people flocked to see this specimen, making its owner, P.T. Barnum, a fortune. The great P.T. Barnum is often credited as being the originator of the
Whoa, a bathtub. Whoa, a chair. And a towel. Whoa, slippers. Oh, a beer can. Tiny slippers. A whale's cave! Oh my god, they have teeth! Oh my god, it's amazing! Oh my god! Something else stolen from Africa. Something else stolen from Africa.
For a businessman, frequent flyer, a lion for a mighty chieftain, a rooster for a common flex, their social status.
A person's anaconda.
Last for up to 18 hours is the culmination of their life. People will go to the lifelong debt rather than cut back on funeral expenses. All famous apocalypse. These creations are a funeral essential, but also great works of hope. first marketed by Kanye Quay, the inventor of fantasy coffins in the 1950s. His family's fantasy coffins have been displayed in galleries around the world, and Ripley's is proud to own and display them in over a dozen.
He stole everything. If you don't take this shit back to Africa, more stolen artifacts.
Human hair vest.
Oh wow. Portrait of Skittles, that's a little bit of. Oh wow, yeah, he grew a beard. That's oh wow. Oh, she pierced her tongue with a lip. That's amazing. Oh, you could do a handstand. What? No.
Never mind. What?
Oh, wow. £850. That's amazing. Oh, wow. Snake and ivory. That's amazing. You don't have any teeth. That's amazing.
Either.
That's amazing.
Yeah, Mom.
No, it's not. It's a challenge.
Hold on, then, Mom.
Oh, wow. They were amazing. Oh my God, I'm getting dizzy.